The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, received the body of the fallen former minister Joyce Mpanga at the stairs of Parliament before proceeding to lay in state for public viewing. The special sitting started in the afternoon and the Deputy Speaker, Tayewa, led Parliament in paying tribute to the late Joyce Mpanga. Tayewa hailed Mpanga as a leader who inspired young women to be educated at a time when the society considered education as a preserve for the male. Mpanga is the former Minister for Women Affairs, former Minister for Primary Education, and former Woman MP for Mwende District in the 6th Parliament. Mpanga was also the first woman to join the Uganda Legislative Council in 1960. Tayewa commended Mpanga for fighting for the marginalized in her legislative time.
She has been one of the few living Ugandans who have witnessed Uganda's history from colonialism to the present day. A Fulbright program alumni of Indiana University, her participation as the first Uganda woman inspired many young women to go to school at a time when society was promoting men a boy child.
Rukia Isanga Nakadama, the third deputy prime minister, led government in paying tribute to Mpanga, describing her as a celebrated educationalist, women rights activist, and veteran politician who served in various political and public places.
Aware that Honorable Joyce Mpanga was a celebrated educationist, women rights activist, and veteran politician who served in various key positions in the political and public service of Uganda, including the first female representative to the Legislative Council in 1960.
The opposition also suspended their boycott to attend today's sitting. The leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, described Mpanga as a spirited patriot, a mother, and incorruptible leader, and a key pillar in the democracy of Uganda.
As I conclude, I'd like to applaud her as a mother for taking care of her children. She's not leaving behind a problem to the nation, but rather very diligent servicemen and women of this, our motherland.
Mpuuga, who served with Mpanga in the Buganda Kingdom, reiterated her contribution to the review of education policies in Uganda.
To some of us, loyal servants of His Majesty, she was a role model. People like the Honorable Muyingo, with whom we served, will attest to the fact that she was loyal, and we owe her.
Other legislators poured in their glowing tribute to the late and asked government officials to emulate Mpanga, who served different positions in government but never engaged in corruption, saying Uganda is losing the war on corruption.
After she had completed her primary education in Nalinya Lwantale, which is in Luwero district, she went to Gayaza, where she was elected head girl for 2 consecutive years. This is not very, it has not happened to anybody before, just because of her great performance.
Before us is of our dear sister, our dear friend, a freedom fighter, a dedicated wife, a widow who can feed orphans without begging anywhere, a woman who has demonstrated that you give me education, I can do anything over and above what a man can do. This is the lady before us.
The late made a fundamental contribution in formulating the national gender policy. I remember very well, she was very particular on the issue of gender mainstreaming. We need to reflect now, as we pay tribute to her, how far we have gone on the issue of gender mainstreaming.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.